Well, good day, everyone. Let's jump right in. The protein complex is not a good one today. As I go to tape here, all three of the products are in the red. We've had some decent selling in the cattle complex, and that's kind of now rolled over into, obviously, as I go to market here, lean hogs have taken it on the chin. The front's worse than the backs, but still a little bit of a rollover. And while it was the lone bull for a while, it's kind of acquiesced is probably a big word for that. But we've now given back about 25% of the rally. So keep that in mind. That's what the technicians will be kind of looking at. But I also want to use this as a great teaching tool. This is a time where you want to get that risk down on paper. We've been saying that the last few times we've gone to tape here, but we just don't want to look at these long-term rallies like a gift horse in the mouth, right? It's going to give us an opportunity to price some animals and move some money off the table and take some risk off the table. And the hardest part to do about that is make that decision. But if you write it down and start with your marketing plan, it makes it a lot easier than using the products that we've got here at the CME group are all going to make those things go smoother and help you manage that going forward when it comes to marketing both your grain and your protein. So keep that in mind. We've had such a tremendous run here. I'd also like to probably give a little bit of a 2 cents on the dollar. Both sides of the aisle are expecting some sort of deal when it comes to the stimulus. And what that means is that there's going to be more money out there. And what that means is that should, technically speaking, weaken the dollar and the market's trading that way. And so I would say be careful because right now it's getting into that election volatility time. We've got both sides of the aisle wanting a stimulus, depending on the size and where it's going to be focused is where the arguments still kind of lie. But either way, it's going to be big. And either way, it's a lot of cash. And either way, that should weaken the dollar. So that should be overall supportive to this. It's hard to say that right now in the face of all the protein markets being off today. But again, once we finally do get that deal, you might even find that the market actually strengthens on that as far as the dollar goes because we finally have the facts out there instead of all this hyperbole and speculation. So again, a weaker dollar, at least talk of a weaker dollar or the feelings of a weaker dollar could help come in and underpin this market at some point in time. Because again, we've seen all these protein, the whole protein complex is red today on the sell side. But if we can just slow that roll, have this dollar help support things, do some work sideways in those graphs and those charts, and that could also give us a nice little boost or at least some sort of bottom to the market here. We can see these things continue to go from the lower left to the upper right. So keep an eye on that, but it's going to get a little bit dicier here as we go into this election because of the dollar talk and because we've got because of what we've got happening to our demand and these lockdowns and those types of things. So lots to talk about here. Market kind of rolling over today. Keep that in mind, and we'll check in with you again next week.